it's like what's the game where you have to try and get across the board? Blockbusters.
That's such a 90s reference. All right, welcome everyone. You join us as we continue to follow Martin's journey to collect the graded run of the 96 original Star Wars Kenner figures. That's right, it's Making the Grade Part 15. Last time out, Martin dropped the bombshell that he sold his second Jedi Knight Blue Saber Luke to raise some funds for his remaining players in the quest. He actually sold it for £210 after paying £140. So that's quite good. That £210 come off his total, and his average last time was £91.30. And after collecting additional five figures, most of which were last 17, I should add, in his previous episode, the average is now £92.12. So wow. That's not too bad. Yeah, that's not too bad. Because they were quite...
That almost seems wrong, but I'm sure you've worked it out correct.
Yeah, maybe. Maybe. Well, it helps that you've just sold one for 210 as well. True. So that's sort of taken a little bit of the hit somewhat. So you're up to... You've got another five figures this week to show us again, haven't you?
So
let's get into that.
I'm gonna crack straight into it this week. So the first one I picked up now, this one I picked up from Echo Base in October last year.
Wow.
So people will realize how far behind we are in this series.
Yeah, we are a little bit, hence why I've taken the days off the graphic. Another reason for it. Yeah
when we finish the series, hopefully, if we ever finish the series, we'll just do sort of a rough estimate of how long it's taken,
but we'll work it out then.
This one was from Echo Base in October, and it was the only, I think it was one of the only things I picked up on that day. I think we picked up a few sort of gifty things in our challenge, but this was the main item I picked up, and it was a 1981 Forlom. It's an old case style. It's a Hong Kong COO. It's UKG graded 80%, but it does have a paint score of 90%, figure score of 85%. But what brought it down to an 80 was it's the cloak was an 80, so it brought the overall score down to an 80%.
So that's quite interesting. I would have thought that would go down as an 85 then, or does it always go to the lowest number?
I must admit, I thought exactly the same as you, because I just double checked it before we started recording, because I was thinking, that's surely not right. It should be the median figure, shouldn't it? But obviously not. So maybe, you know, I'm sure they made a mistake.
Maybe someone can shed some light on how that works in the comments section. I don't know,
it looks absolutely fine. I mean, the cape, I mean, it doesn't look perfect. I mean, I have to say, if you caught our pickups video from a few weeks ago, Adam picked up a loose Forlom, and his looked absolutely like, he looks like an 85 to 90, didn't he? He looked really good.
I'm hoping. Well, I mean, I would never know, because I don't think I'll send it for grading, but it's in very good condition.
But this one is, I mean, it looks fine. It looks perfect, you know, for my display and for collecting the full 96. So this one cost me £70. So I'd say that's not bad. I tried to knock him down to like 60, but he wasn't having any of it. So, you know, I got it for 70. So, I'm fairly okay with it. It's not the best bargain I've ever had, but if anyone thinks I've overpaid, you know, don't tell me in the comments. The second pickup. Now, this was the second one I picked up from Sandown. In the last episode, I mentioned that I picked up that Princess Leia Organa from episode 4. This was the second one I picked up. And this one is a 1983 Bib Fortuna. It's a Taiwan COO. It's UKG graded 90% gold, so it's a top-notch quality looking grade, and it looks like it as well. Looks like it's fresh out of the factory, to be quite honest with you. And because of that, and again, I did a deal with the guy because I bought two. This one cost me £150, and I've had a quick look at what these have gone for, a 90 grade, and I think I've got a bit of a bargain here, having knocked it down a little bit. So, this was from Sandown last November.
I thought you already had a Bib Fortuna.
Well, I had a loose Bib Fortuna that I was going to send off to be graded.
Oh, right.
But, okay, this is what happened. We went to Andy's Totten Toy Fair, wasn't it? And we picked these up.
That's right.
Was that right? Yeah. I picked up four figures, which I thought they were in packets and I sort of jiffy bags, and I picked them all up. They all had weapons. I was like, oh, I might send them off to be graded. But when I got home, I opened the jiffy bags, and the guy who I'd bought them from had obviously kept them in an ashtray because they absolutely stank of cigarette smoke. I mean, they were vile, Adam, honestly. They really, really stank. Yeah. So I did a bit of research, and I found out that if you put them in coffee granules, in a tub of coffee granules,
I remember the smell of smoke out.
Yeah. So I did that for a week, and it did get the smell out, but they just, you know, one of the legs was slightly yellowed and discolored. Right. And I thought to myself, well, I'm not going to probably get a 70 or 75 for these. Mm-hmm. So I've added those on the bottom shelf of the display case, which you can't see, my collection of loose figures, which I will definitely not be starting a loose 96 collection at any point.
that one's for me. We'll follow my journey on that one.
Exactly. Yeah.
The smell of smoke towards it won't affect the grade in any way, though, will it? So
I don't think so, but as I say they were pretty good, Nick, but having I've been doing this for over collecting graded figures and researching graded figures for it's got to be 14
well
15
over
months
a year,
now,
yeah.
roughly
yeah.
and I have to say I've got a small amount of knowledge now about what I think a figure would be, what I think it would be graded as, and I have to be honest, I don't think they would be good enough to get. I mean, I've said that's dropped down to 80s. I'd like to think it would get an 80, but is it worth risking paying the money to send
that's
it out
right,
to be graded?
Yeah.
I don't know. So,
no.
Having looked at, you know, what I paid for this one and looking at what people pay for 90% bids, I think I've got a bit of a bargain here. So, you know, whether I pass on the other, no one's going to buy that other loose Bib Fortuna from me because obviously I've given it a good backstory, but
pass it on. I may need one for my 96 run, so when the time comes, if I put them in a cabinet, I won't be able to smell them at least.
So that's very true. We have to ask Drew if he does a smell free cabinet. third figure is a 1980 Lando Calrissian Bespin, and on the label it's labeled as a variant no teeth, so I think I don't know if you look at a lot of the Lando's Bespin Lando's, you can see the white teeth, you know, they're quite prominent on the figure, whereas this one has none of that, so that would be why. It's a Hong Kong COO, and it is AFA graded, so it's one of the rare AFA graded figures I have, and it's an 85 near mint plus, which if you listen to the experts out there is probably a 90% gold if it was UKG. And I got this one from eBay and it cost me £57.
Okay,
so I think for an AFA 85 near mint plus, that's a pretty good bargain. I don't know if a no teeth variant is a rarer of the variants. Oh, I haven't done that research.
No.
Again, there's people in the who watch this series who know a lot more about that sort of stuff than I do. So please put in the comments if it is a harder to get hold of variant. I don't know, but really, really happy with this one. Obviously, you know, I need to get this one. Good price. Looks absolutely stunning. Although I prefer the way UKG displays the figures in the cases, I have to say there's something nice about having the AFA label on the side. I can't really explain.
It feels like you're getting more for for your grade, I suppose. Yeah.
I think you're getting, I don't want to say more, a better grade, better grading, a better grading company. I don't want to say that.
No.
But you know, from the experts of the videos I do watch, they always say, you know, AFA, they're very, they're a lot more, I should say.
They're stricter.
They're more strict. And yeah. So to get a high AFA grade, it's really nice. And for such a low price as well.
Yeah. Yeah. Good.
So, yeah.
Nice. Nice. Okay. Moving on.
And the fourth figure I picked up is an ATAT driver, not AT-AT driver, as the kids will call it. It's a no COO. It's UKG graded 85%. It's from Another League Toys, first one this week. Yeah. And that one cost me £85. So I think decent. Looking at...
you're bringing the average down this week, I think.
I think so. It's quite a good week for the average. So yeah, really, really happy to have this one.
Very good.
Yeah, it's I think it completed one of the Empire Strikes Back shelves on the display cabinet. So it's really weird. When I complete a shelf row, it's like a moment. Yeah. It's like a bit of a moment.
It's like playing bingo.
It's like what's the game where you have to try and get across the board? Blockbusters.
That's such a 90s reference.
Okay.
Last one for this week.
Yeah, last one. Final figure. A top quality classic figure, a lot of people's favorite figure from the original line, a 1980 Han Solo Bespin, no COO, UKG graded 85%, and this one cost me £85. And again, it was from Another League Toys.
Good old Dan.
Always gets a mention. I'll tell you, I should get more of a discount. I'll tell you. I hope he watches these. This one's a really great figure. Obviously, a lot of people, you know, will say, I've heard this from a lot of people, that this is their favorite childhood figure. It's Han Solo, everyone's favorite character, or a lot of people's favorite character. However, I do have a bit of a gripe with this figure. After a close inspection, it's got an 85 paint grade, but I don't know whether it's happened in the case, but he kind of has a bit of a quiff at the front of his head or his hair. And you can see it's got quite a bit of paint rub there, where it's either been overgraded or it's hit the front of the plastic case and it's it's worn away the paint there. So
does it seem loose in the case then, or
no? It doesn't seem loose at all. So maybe it's a case of overgrading from UKG. But you know, if it was an 80, I still would have picked it up, because you know, it's a reasonable price, especially for Han Solo Bespin. It's a great figure. As I said in previous episodes, I've got to try and drop my grey a little bit.
It's going well so far, isn't it?
I was going to say, about 8 episodes ago, I decided that I was going to drop down to an 80 if I could get an 80 with an 85 paint grade. I think the last 2 episodes, there's been one 80 grade. And I've had 3 90s, so it's not going well, but
it's going very well. I don't know. It depends which way you look at it.
I was going to say,
you've still got
the deals I've got.
You've still got a 75 grade Chewbacca in there, haven't you?
Yes, that was one of my original three that I picked up.
I think it was the first. Yeah, one of the first ones. Mm. Are you going to move that one on soon, or are you going to look
I feel, because they were my first. They were the ones that I saw in a graded case for the first time, and sort of made me fall in love with how they look in graded cases. That I feel like I've got to keep those. You know, they're like my.
That's what kicked this all off, I suppose. Yeah,
they kicked it all off, and they feel like they're my childhood toy. You know, they're the thing that I first got, and I was like, oh, I want to, you know, continue collecting these. You know, just like I did when I was a little kid. You know, I had my tub of Star Wars figures, and I'm sure when I was young, I had one or two to start with, and you know,
just grew.
I think I'll keep hold of him. And at the end of the day, I don't need a better graded Chewbacca. You know, he's not the most, you know, not a good looking character.
Not much
is
to
he?
It, no.
No, exactly. So it's all good. It's all good. But in the future, there'll be some more 80s. Bit of a spoiler. There's possibly maybe even a 75 coming up.
Is that?
Okay. Yeah. So, but we'll keep that for the next episode, I think.
Okay, brilliant. That's it then for this week. Let's have a look where that takes us and how much that's come to. Hopefully you all enjoyed that episode. If you did, make sure you hit that like button, subscribe to the channel if you haven't already, and we'll catch you in the next one. We'll see you later.
Bye.